Sign up today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi folks, Basil Chapman here, and it's my pleasure to be at the Tiger Technicians Hour, 877-927-6648. When I say want to market, what I mean by that is that it's a visceral feeling. You can feel the shorts waiting for this market to collapse, and you can feel the buyers coming in. It isn't often like this. You get these big swings, but usually it's kind of a macro feel that you have. This is a micro feel. This is a feeling that says, I know since Sunday night I've been saying to myself, for subscribers to my opening call, are we going to short the market? Do we have a particular area that we'd like to short? But if it's a leading sector, every time that there's just even a glimpse, even if the, you know, it's right now outside here, Newton Mass, we've got some clouds in the sky. I hope the sun comes out, even if it just peaks out, because I want to be playing tennis later this afternoon. But this is exactly what we're looking at here. We're waiting for the little peep of the sun, just a squeak of a ray of sun, and you can get a big move, a percentage move up in the market to come down now. Well, I don't want to take time. I'm going to talk about it based on my – let me just see if I can get it right here, make it real easy. All right. Is that the one? I hope it is. Here we go. Yes. So this is my dark cloud cover. I've still got it in blue. I have not made it in red yet. Blue is kind of your – it's a high level. And it says that that pattern that we've been looking at, the match from around about August of 2019, we're in that position. Somehow or other, we're in the range. We should be much lower. We should be much higher. Heavy thunderstorms this afternoon. Boss says, yep. But in the meantime, look. You've had an opportunity to crunch to the downside, and you're not taking, but you've had an opportunity to power to the upside. You can't do it, and yet, get out of this. Let me show you something else. We're going to go through this one at a time. Just make it real clear. At any point in the next 2 weeks, it could be days, but I'm saying the next 2 weeks, if the Dow slumps below 25,500, I suspect that the selling pressure is going to be maintained for a little longer. If there is a move above 26,460, but actually if it is a move, it doesn't have to close, just has to be a some kind of a spiral up to 26,650, I think we've broken out and we're going to see the Dow attempt to make a test of the high of 27,580 that was made in on the 6th of August. So that's exactly where we are. We're in the middle of the range. If you look at the Dow right now, you'll see it's really a very mixed picture. One of the things, of course, is Boeing. Boeing is now down almost 3 points at 176. That's kind of putting pressure, but it's not just Boeing. There are other stocks. There's some that are good, some that are – let's see what Microsoft is doing. Microsoft is trading right now at – MSFT is trading at – it's acting quite well. It's up 3, made a new all-time high yesterday, peak. I'm calling this a peak E in the daily, only a leg C in the weekly. You see, this is the whole thing. I haven't got those peaks in the weekly chart to say that the next move down should be a major move. If you're looking at, I don't want to get sidetracked, I want to finish this thought. The S&P made a higher high over that arch that was made. I didn't type it in, but it was at about 31.56 or something. Let me just check. 31.55.53. Yeah, 31.55. So it popped over that the other day. It made a high yesterday of 31.66.44. We're trading up 6 points at 31.51 because remember there was a late hour sell-off and it was this morning as well. But so far, the MACD is just, I mean, it's crossed positive and it's holding. That's number one. Number two is, you know, I had a whole masterclass an entire day. I think I'm looking forward to doing one again sometime in the near future. But in the meantime, look, the green line EMA is way above the 14-period moving average. That suggests that the S&P would have to really crack and close under 3,100, probably under 3,090 to get a sell mode articulation in the daily chart with the lowercase h going to the lowercase m, which is then failing. Usually when it makes a second high, a second R that's higher, it kind of holds for a little while longer. It could even revert back to a bull move and try to tackle the 32.33 high. So far, this is really quite good action when you think of the backdrop, increased cases of coronavirus. Remember, all I'm saying is, look at the deaths. I've been saying that for about 8 weeks, 9 weeks now. I've been saying, please don't get carried away with the number of people being infected, because in fact that's kind of it's kind of what you want to see. Build up some immune system. It's deaths, and the deaths are coming down sharply everywhere. All right, I hope it stays that way, for goodness sake. QQQ. Trading at 258.60, made an all-time high of 260.88 yesterday. A leg D today, maybe making a peak D, but the MACD is good. Stochastic's flat at 91%. On-balance volume isn't overbought. It's in the high range, but it's not overbought. Look at the 9-period moving average, way above the 14. I have to tell you, even though in my gut I'm saying to myself, even yesterday, even today, even 10 minutes before my show, I was saying, should I send out a notice here to start looking at the short side? I think I just have to wait. I don't have technical verification of it yet. I have emotional, but not technical. I have to wait for my indicators to give me that. IWM, there's a diverse nature of this market, this bifurcated market. It is lousy. It's down 15 cents at 140.74. Lowercase h going to a lowercase m, a very lowercase m. MACD is very negative. Stochastic's negative. I don't see anything here because the weekly's gone to the PD. It could consolidate a little longer. When I talk about a bifurcated market, you've got to just check this out. I mean, even within the Dow, you've got some stocks that are not performing, some stocks that are performing well. All right, so now what we want to look at is, look at the XLK. XLK has made a leg E, probably a peak E today with a high yesterday, all-time high, but only a leg C in the weekly. Oh, I didn't finish my thought there. The QQQ is only in leg C in the weekly chart. The S&P is only in leg at peak C in the weekly chart. I have to say we're going to have to wait. I think we're going to have to wait, and then we're going to get a pretty deep. I can see over the next 2 months, I can see a one-week phase that drops 2,000 points in the Dow. I can just see the whole thing coming together with that dark cloud cover where the news really gets bad, and then people start saying, wait a minute, are we going to have this going into the real part of the election period, which will be between August and late September, early October? That's going to be really ugly. But let's deal with it later. In the meantime, back at the ranch, as I said earlier in the update, leg D in gold, and the gold has done the one-to-one after the Chapman-Wave falling X formation, extension to the upside, gone higher. It did a high today of 1829.8. This is only a leg C in the weekly chart, leg E in the monthly. I mean, that, as I said, for all the time. Remember, I had a question from actually a subscriber. We do not have it in my opening call. I have to ask my subscribers, forgive me. I've been focusing on so many other things. I just didn't want to get involved with the gold stocks at this point, but they have been wonderful movers. My mistake. We've had some great, 70% gain in one. Just great picks, but hey, these things have moved. GDX, I see, don't get out of it.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS profile scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Pablo, I just had a question that Dan, what about APT? What is APT? APT is Alpha Pro Tech, trading at 17.84, up $1.13. Yeah, look at this daily chart on the left, holding the 14-period moving average, made a peak C. That peak C had the characteristic of a D until you look at the MACD, the moving average convergence, divergence, and the 9 and the 14-period moving average, and you say, oh, no, 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 that didn't even give a sell signal, down arrow. So this is good at 17.80. I would say to you that it needs 18.40s. You need to get into this area right here above the 1859. I see 1859 was the high of the 30th of June. 1840s would be great, good. And then the very next step, without even making a peak, if it can do that, continue into the 1860s, because that would say, hey, look at that monthly chart. You remember the pattern that I love to look at is when you got a big spiral to the upside, then you come down, or it's the other way around. But then what I always do is I grab the upper part, grab the lower part, and I make it into a rectangle. Then I say, hey, that's just way too wide. And then I make a smaller rectangle that says, go to the next point on the upside. In this case, it's that high that was made right here. We've got the week of the 6th of March, where the high was 21.65. So that's your first level. And what do I always say? I always say, in a rectangle formation, and this one actually looks like either a cup or a rectangle formation right here. In a rectangle formation, as long as you start your new buy signal and you start holding that as support and the technicals are reasonably good, you can make a smaller time frame, Chapman wave peak A, peak B, peak C, peak D, going towards almost right to the very price or just above the left side target, and then pull back sharply. Well, what have we got here? We've got, so that was, yeah, we've got peak A, peak B, pulls back. This is gray leg A. Yeah, I have changed nothing. I've got even a smaller, this is the smaller one, right in the 120-minute chart. I did that right here for you. This is the 120-minute chart. Acting very, you don't want to see a close today under 1760. That'll say, it was just a one-time thing. But look at the way it's held support. Look at the MACD possibly deflecting higher in the daily. Stochastic's not good, but on-balance volume's good. The relative strength is good. And in the 120-minute, you've got your V-shaped bottom. So far, this is really good looking. So that's my analysis there. Then I had a question. Would I please look? Where did it go? Question was, would I look? Oh, I Have I forgotten the question? In the meantime, I've got some questions, regular questions like Boeing. Boeing is down 1.85, 177. It's not that it's down. It's got this pattern, the lowercase h going to a lowercase m. It's just stuck in a range. You don't want to see it take out 166. 166. That can't be. That's a mistake. You don't want to see it take. So this one here is 160, I think. Low is 166.01. Oh, we're at 176 right now. Yeah, you don't want to see it take out 167 support, because then it's going to retest the 166 quickly. Boeing's just kind of stuck in the range. It's had its big moment. It's going to have 234 was the high of the six. I think it's going to take a while to digest these gains. Okay, this is really important at this particular moment. Why am I looking at the TLT? Because the TLT has been stuck in the rectangle range. You know how important all these patterns are. I just showed them here in the den for, not much has changed. I've been showing the same kind of pattern for, since I've been here, since 2002. I saw my newsletter in 2003. So, you know, when I was thinking the other day, how many charts have I sent out over this particular time? Between 3 or 4 to 10 a day. 5 times a week on weekday market days, multiply that, so about 1,000. Yeah. Plus all the charts I do on the weekend. So what, 20,000, maybe more charts I've sent out. So the pattern, you know, there are certain things that have changed. I've used the 9 and 14 period moving average way more. I've zoomed in to make them important. But we use the MACD, stochastic, the 9 period moving average, 50, 200 period. But it's the patterns. Look at this rectangle pattern. I drew this in ages ago, and we're stuck in the range. You have to close above 166 for the TLT to say, hey, if the market's pulling back when the TLT goes to 166, that suggests it's going to be a deeper decline. But every time there's been a decline, the bonds have just been stuck in the range. I've been saying this for a long time. Stuck in a range. That's all there is to it. It's stuck in a range. And at some point, it's going to change. But just for now, don't think interest rates. I don't think it's an issue right now. Next thing I want to look at is silver. So we had gold acting well. So, oh, look at this. This is a buy mode going to a leg D. That's the objective in the Chapman wave, is a buy mode goes to a buy signal goes to a buy mode. Immediately, the implication is you will not only have a peak C, but you'll get at least a peak D. And here we are in leg D at a new recovery high. And that makes the weekly chart extremely positive. Oh, silver's looking fantastic. So finally, silver's really started to act the way we thought it would if it ever broke out decisively from this Chapman inside track repellent zone. You're only in leg A, B. Oh, let me just do this slowly. A, B, C, D pulls back. A, B. Yeah, only 120-minute chart leg B. Now, the reason why I wanted to keep this 120-minute chart up here, let's just do this one more thing. I wanted to show you crude oil. Crude oil right now, where did that go? Let's just type it in over here. Okay, crude oil is trading at, it's up 26 cents at 40.88. And I said, this is another one of those rectangle formations. I forgot to actually type it in there. There it is, a rectangle formation. And it's still positive. And I said, I want to see crude oil holding well. I'd actually like to see it rally, because that's a good thing for the general market, number one. And number two is, if you're looking at crude oil together with wood, which is the iShares of the Global Timber and Forestry ETF, that's held very nicely. It's gone to ABC, peak C in the weekly chart. I can just get out. Oh, I don't really want to move the 120-minute chart. But the daily chart says it's got an H to a lowercase m pattern. So that's not great, but it's holding okay. I want to see that. I want to see international timber and forestry ETF moving up. I want to see crude oil moving up. I want to see high-grade copper moving up, HG, high-grade copper. Oh, look at that, up 0.02 today, 2.82. Wow, we were looking at under 2 back in March, and now look where it is. It's in leg D in the data. And this is the reason why I'm saying I'm kind of, well, one foot is hovering over the break. The other foot is on the accelerator. We've added stocks. I shouldn't have done that. I'm going to talk about, I had a new subscriber ask me about what are the positions for the day. because it was later than the newsletter went out, I always have a tough time to treat it as if it was a new trade, because my trade is at a particular time, particular instance. So I said to wait now. What we just bought this morning to add to our long positions is up. Sorry about that. Okay, so I'm going to talk about this in a minute. I'll come back to it. So high-grade crop is acting well. It's gone above the 200-period moving average in the weekly chart. Last time it stalled right there, and that was in December or January. January, the week of the 17th, 2.90. It hit it at peak D. Look how important the Chapman Wave fourth highest peak is at peak D. And then look what happens sometimes. Wow, look at that slide from the just over 2, well, around 2.90, and it goes under 2. Hey, I'd call that 30% of the time. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman does at 55 S&P's at 10 would be like that.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman Wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, we're back. Dow's up 52. S&P's up 9.88. So I had a question that Dan Peake wants to know. Basil, is silver potential cup and ladle 1D or cup too shallow? No, this is perfect. As a pattern, but it's leg B or C that you want to see go straight to the left side high in the silver contract. That's the continuous. 19.10 was the high of the 1st of June. If I did this, and I actually had done this, and then I changed it about a week ago, I was busy and I forgot to formulate it. There is a ChapWave cup. There's a ChapWave inside track repellent zone. Everything's there. but it went through that left side high today in leg D. So that doesn't, Chapman ladle is specific. Why is it specific? Because in the Investor's Business Daily, and they use it in a particular way, and they use it fantastically, but it's a particular way. If you don't use it that way, to my experience, you're invariably on the handle of a cup and handle pattern, come back into the handle. So I don't see the benefit, other than it's, if you get it right, it's a great starting position, but it always gets retested within a couple of points. Mine is completely different. I discovered years ago that if in the cup formation or V-shaped formation, you take out that left side high that was made at a peak D, E, or F and had a significant pullback, you take that out in either a leg B or a C, there's just an absolute, not a guarantee, but like a 90% chance that you're going to go to at least a D before you come back and retest the left side lip. But I've seen it go to E and an F and then come back. In fact, come back and not even test that left side lip. So this is in a leg D. If this was called C, I'd say, wow, it's going even higher. Now I have to say, be careful. We're just about to get to some kind of resistance, but it is really bullish. The MACD cross positive. Stochastic still has a long way to go. It's only at 78%. I like 80%. I like it higher than 80%. But look at the weekly chart. Leg C breakout with a really strong MACD. Stochastic at 86%. I do like it. So just make it real clear. Either the V or the cup formation, it's usually the cup formation. That's why I call it a cup and ladle, is it goes zooming through the left side high in leg C. Maybe it's a B, but it's usually a C, and that C goes higher, closes above that left side high, and then goes to, pulls back, and then goes to a D. And then the ladle, so this is exactly what we were looking at. ESU2O, that's exactly not what we were looking at. Oh, it's this one here, CERS. This is the stock that we have. Nope, it's not that. Oh, for goodness sake, what stock was it? I'll find it during the break. I'll try to find it. And yeah, so it's a pattern that is really decisive because it takes off in the ladle formation and keeps going higher. All right, so that's that question. Oh, APT is now taking off. We did a nice analysis. Oh, 18.16. Very nice, Dan in the Den. All right, so this is what I wanted to talk about. Look, let me write. Have I done all that I wanted? Yes. So here we go, Alphabet. So someone had asked me about our stocks. I really don't like to do this, but I am going to say, look, this is A, which is Agilent. We've had it since 70.69. Taken a little bit from the way up, but we still have our core, a very nice core position. It's trading at 89. It went to 93. That's a huge gain. 70 to 93, 23-point profit. And then the paper profit, and then we took off something on the way down, and we're still holding it. And it's making this left side H to the arch pattern, which is H to an M pattern, but like the S&P, it's gone a little higher to 89.02 over 89.79. All right, that's not really what I wanted to show you. I wanted to go through the alphabet. Here we go. Apple, A-A-P-L. Apple, I said before, I think this is G/C. I don't think it's a G. I think it's more like a C, but we're getting close to some kind of a top. And if I go to my ChapmanWave automated resistance points, do you remember what we were looking at? We're looking at Apple had 375. It's trading right now 379.94. Just took it out, took out the weekly resistance. 384 to 385 is the automated ChapmanWave 120-minute chart. Resistance levels quite a bit higher. So far to me, that says we've got this rotation going on, and it's going to be very selective. I think we are forming some kind of at least a shorter-term top. But wow, to actually trade it and play it is really tough. Look at Amazon, AMZN, all-time high today. Had a round number 3072 high yesterday. Yeah, forget about it. Today it opened at 307.2.00 round number. Let's keep that in mind. It is leg E, but the MACD is good. Stochastic's at 92% and flat. I'd have a tough time thinking it's coming down. Look at the 120-minute chart, leg D. Let's look at team, which we spoke about yesterday. That is Alt Atlassian Corporation. made a peak C yesterday in the Chapman Wave inside track rising. Resistance zone is just above it right now. Yesterday went above it and pulled back. 196.35 yesterday. 196.27. You're 9 cents away from making a new all-time high to a leg D and then a leg D in the weekly chart. And look at this 120-minute chart. 1A. B, C, it's just about to go to a leg D. You can see why I'm saying I'm getting a little bit nervous just in terms of some kind of a pullback in these real big leaders. And at the same time, the secondary tier and third tier of the tech sector, which we've tried to get into, which is working quite well. We'll see if money then goes to this. So let's look at Goog. This is Alphabet. Oh, it's so hard to say Alphabet. It's Goog. Google is trading up 1166 at 1496, made an all-time high yesterday. I don't know if I call this a G or a brand new A. Oh, it's fantastic. But the weekly is in a D, and the 120-minute chart is at a peak D. So you can see even here, what were you looking at? Facebook. Facebook is trading up 0.04 at 240.90, even with all the yelling and screaming that's going on. Just like Google, it had this inside ABCD, pulls back very sharply from 245.19 on the 23rd of June. But in the big picture, if I call that PE and this is an F, maybe this is a G slash A. G is very negative. A is really positive. How do you analyze that? All you do is you say the MACD is just cross positive. Stochastic's only at 81%. On balance volumes are very strong. This is holding very nicely on Facebook, even with all the stuff that's going on. It's only at a peak C in the 120-minute chart. So I just wanted to say to you, it is really hard to pull the trigger here and say, let's go short one of these sectors. Yeah, you could go short the IWM, but what if we pull back in the queues and all of a sudden money goes back into the IWM as it's done so many times when everything else starts to slide? Is that an A? Or could be a rogue wave. Wait, that was what we were looking at? Oh, Facebook. Is that a rogue wave? Yeah, it doesn't have the characteristic of a rogue wave because it's been so strong. It's gone from the 208-ish area, 207, all the way to yesterday's high in the 246s, 247s. That's more than a rogue wave. Wow, if that's a rogue wave, then it's like the Canadian. No, it's like the Alaskan. Oh, what was I reading in the book, The Wave? Up there in Alaska, they've got this estuary, this water, and the tide comes in, the tide goes out, and it creates a wave that sometimes can go to 1,000 feet high. People try to surf these things on 1,000 feet, but at least 110. Anyway, so yeah, I don't know about that being a rogue wave. Dow's up 38, S&P's up 9, Basil Chapman, Tiger Denison's out. We got a ton to do, got a lot to go through. I'll be right back.
The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metals sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-Share Bull and Bear ETFs. China A-Shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7000. 7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
So, of course, during the break, I've been so busy either answering some questions or either email or in the den that I almost forgot where I was. So just let me show you this. How important are the peak D's and E's in the ChapmanWave methodology? Yes, the two-minute chart made a peak E back there at about 10:15. And in the 31.62 area, pulls back sharply to 31.25, runs all the way up to 31.46, and now making another peak E pullback in the two-minute chart. I had a question here about the TLT. Yes, so Greg, this is something you might think about this. Do you remember I spoke about this for many years now? My book, a CD, Introducing the ChapmanWave Methodology, talks about peak A, peak B, C, D. But over the years, and it's really a long time, it's more than 10, 12 years, I've been saying I've begun very much to count the inside peaks. That's your obligation in the ChapmanWave, to count each peak and trough. And so, yes, the TLT made a low at 153.16 on the 5th of June. Then it had a huge leg A, then it pulled back, and then inside there was a little peak A. I call it a gray A because it's under the others. I didn't have a chance to change the color. And then a gray B, and then you get a combined move to the upside, and it goes to a C, and then pulls back, and now we're at a D. If I did it the old way, I'd be saying, yeah, this is a C. But remember, if you count each bar, my objective in the ChapmanWave is to get you to a D, get you a turning potential turning point at the quickest opportunity, not the longest. Because, look, if I was thinking this is still a C, and all of a sudden we pull back very sharply, I'd say, hey, where's the D? This way I'm ready for anything. I don't have to do anything in D. The MACD is good. Stochastic said at 75%. So I'm just watching this closely. So, yeah, I hope that helped you. So that's a good question, and I hope I've given you a good, a cogent answer. So talking about good question, good answer, I get capital letters. You should read the second day. You should read about the tulip bulb craze. You might learn something. So you see, that a statement like that is a derogatory statement. It's a statement saying, you know nothing. I know so much, and you know nothing. How about the tulip? I've been talking about the tulip bulb before you were born. So I don't want to hear that, okay? You like Greg gave me a cogent question, and I gave a cogent answer. What am I supposed to answer here? Other than I've read hundreds of books on the crash of 1929, I've given webinars on 1929. I've given webinars on stuff that people have never spoken. I've never seen anybody speak about Goldman Sachs' IPO, the skyscraper craze that gave the exact top. Tulip bulb, I've read tons of books on the tulip bulb craze. So I don't know what you're saying, all right? So it's not me that really has to learn. You have to learn how to ask the question. If the question is, have you read the tulip bulb about the tulip bulb? Because it doesn't sound like you know it. I'm saying to you, I don't just know about the tulip bulb. I've discussed it right here if you've been listening for a long time. So We aren't in the tulip bulb phase. Not yet. We will get there. So have patience. You'll get your opportunity. Then I want to see big bold letters saying, is this the tulip bulb top? But until then, don't waste my time. The EEM, good question on the EEM. EEM is the emerging market. Oh, I didn't notate this. So this is peak A, B. I'll do it right now live. Peak A, let's just do this because we've got two breaks. So yeah, before the next break, A, B, C, D, E. I'm calling this an F. But that D has every single characteristic of an instant restart, Chapman Wave instant restart. Another one of those techniques that I've developed over the many, many decades that I've done this. And let's look at it. And I'm going to say, yeah, it has that characteristic. It looks pretty good. The MACD in the weekly is very strong. Stochastic's flat at 90%. I love that. So the EEM is a part. I spoke about this a little while back, but for some reason, I've just taken it off my radar. How silly is that? Trading at 43.27 EEM. Emerging market index. This is another very bullish sign. You've got copper. You've got wood. iShares, Timber and Forestry ETF. Now you're looking at the EEM. Yes, very strong. Will it go to the last high? That's going to be a question for now at 43.27. The last high was 46.32 on the week of the 17th of January. It looks like it could very well get there. I'll do a little more work over this on this over the, overnight and tomorrow. I'll present it with a lot of the techniques that we talk about. So while I'm doing this, let me just see the EWU, which is the UK ETF. And let me just see if I can do this. This is going to be GBDOW. This is the Dow. This is the Dow. Yeah, it's the same thing. The Dow's interpretation of the Dow Jones United Kingdom Stock Index. It should look like the FTSE. I'm not sure if it does. Made a peak F doji. So this has got the lowercase h that goes to a lowercase m, and it's not acting all that well. You see, this is what I'm saying about a bifurcated market. Now you've got the emerging markets doing well, but look at this. England. Let's see with the DE, which is the German index. Yeah, that's doing a little bit better. It looks like it's gone to a peak D in the weekly, and it's gone to peak A. Ho, ho, ho. So you got your top there, you got your bottom here, and now it's gone peak A, B, C. It's at peak D in the daily chart. Oh, this needs to be watched. Yeah, you see, it seems to me that Europe is taking its cue not from our good news of the markets, but it's more on the bad news that they're reading. That's the way it is. That's the way it's looking right now. Because why would the emerging markets be doing way better? All I can say is that it's acting quite nicely, the German market. And we do want to see a 381 down, the close today is down 323, a 381 on the Dow Jones German index. You really want to see it trying to break above the high that was made just a few, whatever the high was of the 6th of July, you want to go above that, close above it, so that you can tackle the most important high that was made on the 8th of June, and on that was that date. All right, those are the couple of questions I got. Got another question here about, yeah, I don't want to go there, I don't want to go there, I don't want to go there. I'm going to have to skip those. I'll do those tomorrow. What I do want to do right now is that I had a couple of questions. Questions pertain to, let me just answer this. So the new subscriber who sent the email to TFNN, then passed it on to me. I sent you how to read the newsletter. I'm just going to say to you, I shouldn't have said to you don't buy because the object was to buy it under a particular level, the one that I mentioned. So I'm going to say to you, if you're going to be strict about whatever it is, you can enter now because it's underneath the level that I said to buy it at. It went a little deeper. You say you're still at a better level than how we got in. But I am going to say to you, it needs to participate very quickly. Everything about it except that sharp pullback today, it went to that peak D in the 120-minute bar. We wanted to buy the pullback. We did everything right. The actual decline was a tad more than I wanted. We did not get stopped out because the first day of the entry, we always have a fairly wide stop. So if you want to get in, just keep the stop that I've discussed for now, and I'll follow it up tomorrow. It could close at the low of the day. It could close towards a nice gain. I don't know. I'm just saying that was the entry. I shouldn't have said to you, I don't do anything. Usually I like to I don't want to give anyone else, a subscriber, an entry point in the stock that was not what I've officially given, because then it becomes my trade. And I don't want to have to sit there holding your trade. Your trade is your trade. I've done all my homework. Now I don't want to add another bunch of homework by giving you a price that wasn't what I originally said. That's all. So it's underneath what you wanted it at, what we wanted it at. If you go in, just be very strict. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Conditions Hour, Dow's up 21, S&P.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, this is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge, heard here at TFNN.com.
So, questions about crisp. This is crisp, whatever the heck it is. Look at this. I have no resistance levels. And yet, look at it in the daily chart. This is a huge move. This is a leg E. It could be a little conservative and maybe call it E/C. But this is amazing. It's now parabolic. But if it goes a little longer, that'll already be parabolic. Right now, it looks parabolic, but it isn't quite 90 degrees yet. But that weekly chart certainly isn't the monthly chart. So it's in leg E daily, leg D weekly, leg D monthly, and crisp is, I keep having to look at this, CRISPR Therapeutics, just an amazing, they're doing something right. I don't want to be thinking short on any of the biotechs. It's just too dangerous. Anything can happen in a biotech. So be careful there. So let me just show you this here. You're going to be handed over to Steve Rhodes. I think Dave White's still away, and you've got Tom O'Brien. Of course, check out my opening call, my daily newsletter. Hopefully you'll find it. A lot of people are saying thank you very much. You've kept us in trades for a long time. It's been a very it's helped them a lot, and that's really important. So what I am going to look at here is, just real quickly, look at the Dow. Dow is not that good. It's just, I've been saying for a while, Dow is stuck in a range between 26,500, maybe 600, not even that, maybe 26,500, and basically 25,500 for a while, and I think it'll stay there for a little while. Now, look at the S&P. The S&P is broken out, but today's action is not that bad. It's down, it's up 8. But I think if it does make a leg D, I want to see not 3195. I actually want to see 3200. And if the S&P gets to 3200, that's going to force the shorts to cover, and it's going to force even new money in. And if you look at the QQQ, it could rotate here a little bit. It might not have to go that much higher, but it could go higher. But at this point, it's at peak D. MACD is good. Stochastic is good. Wow. I'd be going against all my principles if I did what my gut said to do, and that sort of shorten the QQQs. I just don't see it. Maybe they can pull back. So the question I had about the NQ, and basically the question is, Basil, NQ, if it exceeds 10,695. So I've got it at a peak C. Yes, there's an alternate count, but peak C is what I've got. I've got that for some other areas and other key stocks in the NDX. I think there's a chance that it's going to go to 16,695 to start leg D. That's the way it's looking here. I don't know how or why, but that's kind of how it's looking. I hope I answered your question, Z. Have a wonderful